If there's one concept in the film industry today that causes more debate than any other, it's the concept of imitation. So many film scores now are considered derivative of others thanks in part to the temp track, a piece of music that editors will use to edit the film, and then, having associated the film with that music, dislike any music that isn't similar to that. This places film composers in a tricky spot. On the one hand, you want to do something original and creative with your music, and on the other, your bosses and creative overlords are demanding you imitate something that, in all likelihood, someone else wrote. A film composer's job then becomes not to write the best possible score for the film, but to combine these two ideals of imitation and innovation into a film score that satisfies both the director's musical influences and the composer's originality. There's been loads of films that have been successful at achieving this, but today I want to focus on one in particular. This film demonstrates these two concepts in everything it does, and the music reflects this. I am talking about the 2005 film Sky High, and let's consider it in the context of how it innovated and imitated superhero movie scores of the past, present, and future. Sky High is a superhero movie with a Disney Channel twist. It focuses on students at a high school who happen to have superpowers. It's essentially a high school coming-of-age story with a superhero background. Instead of jocks and nerds, you have heroes and sidekicks. Instead of football, there's Save the Citizen. Instead of normal science, you have to assemble a heat ray. And the music also represents this crossover. The main theme is very much a superhero theme through and through, but there are some other moments where the music is more in line with electronica than you would expect from a mid-2000s movie. The licensed soundtrack also includes entirely 80s songs as an homage to John Hughes, who directed the classic school films like The Breakfast Club and Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Okay, so the original soundtrack. I found almost nothing on Michael Giacchino's score for this movie. This was Giacchino's second big film. He did The Incredibles the year before and would go on to do Mission Impossible 3 the year after, and simultaneously he was doing Lost, the TV show. Obviously, more people care about the soundtracks for Lost and The Incredibles because those were super popular. Anyway, point is that this was an interesting time for Giacchino. He hadn't quite established himself in the film space, and this was one of the films that helped show off what he could do. This is Sky High's main theme. If it doesn't scream superhero theme to you, I don't know what to tell you. Everything is here. The brass notes playing a major arpeggio, the driving and tremolo strings, the percussion rolls. Most superhero themes today derive from Fanfare for the Common Man by Aaron Copland. You can hear it in Portals from Avengers Endgame. And in the classic superhero theme of Superman. However, this isn't the only connection to Superman. Giacchino explained in an interview that he was inspired by the classic Max Fleischer Superman cartoons from the early 1940s, around the same time as Fanfare for the Common Man was composed. Giacchino's main theme here is an imitation. It uses the techniques applied by Copland and the Fleischer cartoon to create a piece that is definitely reminiscent of those styles. But this use is deliberate. Sky High's filmmaking process used the past superhero movies to help develop it. Director Mike Mitchell says the project was a dream because of how many cameos and references there are in the film. Linda Carter, Wonder Woman, plays the principal, Kurt Russell, Snake Plissken, plays the father, and Bruce Campbell, Ash Williams, plays the PE teacher. Sky High was a film designed around the very idea of calling back to past heroes and building something new. In fact, this is a theme that plays into the very plot of the film, the concept of family legacy and finding yourself. The music of Sky High is so good because it plays into this theme. Giacchino doesn't imitate classic superhero themes just for the point of it. He imitates them because the very concept of looking into the past has a place in the film, and the music is a brilliant reflection of that. Clearly, then, Sky High honours the past works of superhero films by imitating them to tie into the themes of the film. However, Sky High's soundtrack would also have an impact on the music of the present at the time the film was released. Sky High came out at a very important time for the superhero genre. It came out about a month after Batman Begins, which some would say was the beginning of a new era for the superhero movie. It came out a year after Spider-Man 2, which was considered better than its sequel, Spider-Man 3. Sky High also split the X-Men movies, coming out after X2 and a year before X3, and similarly, X2 was well received and X3 was not so well received. It was also a few years before the beginning of the MCU with Iron Man, releasing in 2008. So Sky High came out at a time where superhero movies in the 2000s were at their peak and just about to fall. Musically, I think Giacchino helped push the genre forward. Admittedly, I haven't listened to the full soundtrack of some of these films, or in some cases even seen the whole movie, sorry X3, but here's an example of a piece from Spider-Man 3. And here's an example from X3. These are both highly orchestral scores. They don't really try and do anything too new or original, and instead opt to keep the same sounds as a lot of other action movies. For comparison, here's the score for Sky High's Save the Citizen. Here, we have a lot more emphasis on synth lines and electronica, which you wouldn't really expect from a superhero movie. At the same time, it kinda makes sense to use these instruments, as electronica is often associated with the youths. However, it's not so much this use of electronica that's impressive, although this would go on to affect electronica in other films such as Black Panther. But more impressive is the combining of the two genres in this superhero movie. And then when you go and listen to Iron Man, which came out 3 years later, there you get electric guitars and synths combined with the orchestral score, which is exactly what Giacchino did here 3 years earlier. Sky High's music helped to enable other genres to mix into the orchestral default of superhero music that had previously existed due to John Williams and Aaron Copland. Also, take a listen to the Captain America march. And now the ending of Save the Citizen. Giacchino's score, while looking to the past, also had a huge influence on the present films that were being released at the time. But what about his future? Well, everything I've been talking about eventually comes together. After Sky High, Giacchino didn't really touch superhero movies for another 10 years. He did the scores for pretty much every Pixar movie and J.J. Abrams movie after that, so he was keeping busy. He returned to the world of superheroes when he did the score for the 2016 MCU film Doctor Strange, and then immediately afterwards he did the score for Rogue One in about 4.5 weeks, which is an insane turnaround. While Rogue One isn't a superhero movie, Giacchino talks about his time composing the score for it and having to balance the old and the new, imitations and improvisations. He says, "The score does borrow from traditions that both John Williams and George Lucas borrowed from when they made the original Star Wars, you know. George was looking at Flash Gordon, the old serials, and John was looking at Gustav Holst and different composers along the way to get a baseline for what he wanted to communicate. There is a wonderful musical language that John put together for the original films. I wanted to honor that vernacular, but still do something new with it, something that was still me, in a way." He straight up admits that for Star Wars, and it would have been similar for Sky High and anything else where homage is paid, that you need to negotiate the past with creating something original. and Giacchino's next superhero film score would make perfect sense. If you were making a movie about a teenage superhero dealing with the consequences of legacy and power while still being a high school movie, who is the most obvious choice to score that film? Someone who has perfectly negotiated the only other major film in that genre before. It should be no surprise that Giacchino scored Spider-Man Homecoming. And for the future, Giacchino is also providing the score for the upcoming The Batman film in 2021. And if the score for that movie utilizes his ability to imitate and honor the past while creating something new, as he did in Sky High, then it's going to be incredible.